Hey guys, Paul from UltimateFatBurner.com here, and today I'm going to answer the question, is creatine safe for teens and children? I'll be right back with the answer, plus four things you need to know if you're a parent who has just found a jug of creatine in your teen's gym bag. I'll be right back in just a couple of seconds. Stick around. Please don't go anywhere. Hey, you're still here. Awesome. Thanks so much for sticking around. So let's get right to it and answer the question, is creatine safe for teens and children? Well, the recommendation of health and medical professionals is absolutely clear. Teens and children should absolutely, positively, definitely not use creatine. Now, if you're a mom or a dad who's watching this video after finding a jug of creatine in your son or daughter's gym bag, or you're a teen who's decided to look a little more closely at what you've been putting into your body, please don't freak out. Here's the four things you need to know about creatine for teens and children before you panic. And please note, we're talking about creatine monohydrate here. It's the gold standard when it comes to creatine supplements. If you or your teen is using some other form of creatine, then the points I raise in the remainder of this video are not necessarily applicable. So let's start with number one. There have been hundreds of studies performed on creatine monohydrate demonstrating its safety and effectiveness even in the elderly and people with various diseases. However, there have not been a ton of studies performed on creatine use in children and teens. And because the bodies of children and teens are still developing, it's not completely known how creatine use will affect them, and therefore it's not recommended they take it. So take a deep breath. It's not that creatine has been proven dangerous in young people. It hasn't. Number two, while there haven't been a lot of studies on creatine use in teens and children, there have been some. In just a few minutes of research, I was able to find four studies, and I'll include links to the studies in the description below this video so you can check them out for yourself. What's important to note is that none of them showed any adverse side effects in the study participants, who ranged in age from 1 to 18 years. That's good news. Number three, creatine occurs naturally in food, in red meats, fish, and poultry, among others. Unless you're a vegetarian, adults consume 1 to 2 grams daily, children somewhat less. So creatine is not something completely foreign to our bodies. Number four, your body produces it naturally. An adult produces between 1 and 2 grams daily, teens somewhat less. So again, just to emphasize, this is not something completely foreign to our bodies. So what's the bottom line? Well, even though it's not recommended, it's not necessarily something you should freak out about unless you or your teen has an underlying kidney or health issue, in which case you should definitely stop its use and consult a medical professional. Now, if you're a parent watching this and you're still concerned about your teen's creatine use, then you want to subscribe to this channel. In my next video on creatine for teens and children, I'm going to outline 7 best practices for using it safely. Okay, guys, that's it for this video. If you liked it, a thumbs up or a share would be awesome. If you hated it, thumb it down. It helps me understand what content you find most valuable. Now, if you have a question or a comment, by all means, leave it below. I'd absolutely love to hear from you. And if you haven't subscribed, please take a minute to do so. It would be awesome to have you as a member of our growing community. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you really soon.